Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jaffrey. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 19th of June. India reinstates lockdown in Chennai as cases surge. Activists raise concern over proposed amendment in interim constitution of Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And Nepal's president approves new map that includes three territories disputed with India. And now for all the details. Authorities in Chennai city of India's southern Tamil Nadu province reimposed a citywide lockdown on Friday as coronavirus cases continued to spike. Tamil Nadu had 52,334 total cases of COVID-19 as of Friday, the second highest in India. Chennai alone on Thursday reported new 1,373 cases of the deadly virus.
Chennai city, home to some 15 million people in India's southern Tamil Nadu, was once again put under lockdown on Friday to curb the spread of the novel coronavirus as the number of positive cases in the province continue to rise rapidly. With 52,334 coronavirus cases, the second highest in India, and 625 deaths, shops remain closed, roads deserted as people stayed indoors during the lockdown in Tamil Nadu. Only few people stepped out to purchase essentials or for essential services, as only that was allowed. Indian government on June 1 eased back on most curbs after a two-month-long nationwide lockdown.
The lockdown has begun and we have just started enforcing the lockdown measures. And in many areas of the city, not only monitoring through drones, even announcement through drone speakers attached to drones, that is also happening. And except for permitted purposes, vehicles and will not be allowed.
India on Friday reported the highest single-day spike of 13,586 new COVID-19 cases and 336 deaths in the last 24 hours, taking the total tally to 380,532. Indian government is now working on a unified strategy to tackle the coronavirus pandemic in worst-affected regions like capital New Delhi and some satellite cities, while it is also arranging for more and more beds for patients across the country. The country has recently converted a spiritual center into what it claims will be the world's biggest temporary hospital with 10,000 beds to treat a surge in the number of COVID-19 cases.
Protests against China continued across India on Friday to condemn the killing of 20 Indian soldiers in a violent border face-off with Chinese troops in the mountainous region of Ladakh earlier this week. Meanwhile, Indian troops remained on alert at the Galwan Valley in the Ladakh region 4 days after the clashes, in which India said China had also suffered casualties.
Protests against China continued across India on Friday to condemn the killing of 20 Indian soldiers in clashes with Chinese troops at a disputed Himalayan border site in mountainous region of Ladakh on Monday. Protesters in India's eastern Kolkata city sent Chinese President Xi Jinping to makeshift gallows as they staged a demonstration. A man dressed as Xi Jinping stood under makeshift gallows as protesters raised slogans and appealed people to boycott Chinese goods. The anger against China and its products was seen in capital New Delhi and northern Lucknow city as well, where people from the country's northeast and Muslims staged protests to criticize the Chinese government.
If need be, we want to mention here that if need be, we will not hesitate to take off weapons to support our soldiers and to protect the territorial integrity of the country.
Meanwhile, Indian troops remained on alert at the Galwan Valley in the Ladakh region, 4 days after the clashes in which India said China had also suffered casualties. China has not given details of any deaths or injuries among its troops and has maintained the situation is stable and controllable. India will take part in a trilateral meeting with Russia and China next week, the country's foreign ministry said on Thursday, with the foreign minister to attend virtually on June 23rd.
A total of 8 militants were neutralized in 2 separate encounters in India's northern Jammu and Kashmir territory in the last 24 hours, officials said on Friday. 5 militants were gunned down in an operation by the security forces in Shopian district, while 3 militants were neutralized in Pampor area of Avantipora district. The army said the encounter site in Avantipora was next to a mosque, so extreme restraint was exercised in order to prevent damage to the structure. Search operations were still on in the area till the last reports came in. India blames neighboring Pakistan helps terrorists infiltrate across the border to mount attacks on Indian soil. Security officials have claimed despite coronavirus pandemic, there has been a spike in activities by Pakistan-backed terror groups. Moving on, political activists have raised concerns over the proposed amendments in the interim constitution of Pakistan-administered Kashmir by the Pakistani establishment. They have described it as violation of fundamental rights of people of Pakistan-administered Kashmir.
Political activists have opposed proposed 14th Amendment Bill in the interim constitution of Pakistan-administered Kashmir by the Pakistani establishment. They have raised concern that the unjust law will give all authorities to directly appointed officers from Pakistan instead of the elected representatives in the illegally occupied region. The provisions include laws restricting any person to participate in political activity which does not believe accession with Pakistan. Activists described it as violation of the rights of self-determination and fundamental human rights of people of Pakistan-administered Kashmir.
ये इंतहाई भयानक किस्म का एक नौ आबादियाती अमेंडमेंट है जिसके ज़रिए आज़ाद कश्मीर को मुकम्मल तौर पर पाकिस्तान की ग़ुलामी में एक दफ़ा फिर धकेला जा रहा है
कि पाकिस्तान ने हमेशा आज़ाद कश्मीर के लोगों पे ऐसे कवानीन अपने सहूलतकारों के ज़रिए मुसल्लत किए हैं जिससे कि आज़ाद कश्मीर के लोगों के बुनियादी सियासी समाजी और माशी हकूक न सिर्फ सलब हुए हैं.
Activists have long raised concerns over the ill treatment of people belonging to Pakistan administered Kashmir. They blame the people of the illegally occupied region have been denied basic fundamental rights and are meted out with severe brutality for voicing their concerns.
Commander of U.S. Central Command, General Kenneth McKenzie, has said that the United States has reduced its troop presence in Afghanistan to 8,600, fulfilling its obligation as part of a February deal with the Taliban.
The United States has reduced its troop presence in Afghanistan to 8,600. Fulfilling its obligation as part of a February deal with the Taliban, Commander of U.S. Central Command Marine General Kenneth F. McKenzie said on Thursday. The deal said the U.S. would drop to 8,600 within 135 days, which is mid-July. It represents a reduction from about 12,000 troops at the time of the agreement. We have met our part of the agreement, McKenzie said, speaking during a webinar by a think tank Aspen Strategy Group. The Taliban struck a troop withdrawal agreement with the United States on February 29th to pave the way for talks with the Afghan government. But the insurgent group insisted a list of 5,000 prisoners be released, leading to months of delay as the Afghan government initially refused to set free that many prisoners before talks. The issue is a final major sticking point which if resolved is expected to lead quickly to intra-Afghan peace negotiations in Qatar, aimed at ending more than 18 years of war in a US-brokered peace process.
Nepal's President Bidya Devi Bhandari has authenticated the Constitution Amendment Bill passed by the country's parliament concerning the controversial new map. The new political map incorporates three disputed territories of Kalapani, Lipulekh and Limpia Dhura, which India also claims.
Nepalese President Bidya Devi Bhandari has signed a Constitution Amendment Bill to update the country's new political map, which incorporated three key territories of Kalapani, Lipulekh and Limpia Dhura, disputed with India. President Bhandari authenticated the bill stepping on the Article 274-10 of the Constitution, a release from President's office said on Thursday. Earlier in the day, the upper house of the Nepal Parliament unanimously passed the Constitution Amendment Bill, providing for the inclusion of the country's new political map in its national emblem. Last month, Nepal released the revised political and administrative map of the country, laying claim over the tri-junction more than 6 months after India published a new map in November 2019. India has repeatedly maintained that the tri-junction in the new map does not belong to Nepal. India says the artificial enlargement in Nepal's new map is not based on historical facts and evidences, and the move is violative of the current understanding to hold talks on outstanding boundary issues.
Sri Lanka opened its first underwater museum in the southern port city of Gull this week ahead of plans to start reopening the country to tourism on 1st of August.
Sri Lanka opened its first underwater museum in the southern port city of Gull on Wednesday ahead of plans to start reopening the country to tourism on 1st of August. The museum was built by the country's navy and is about 50 feet underwater within the port. Navy Commander Vice Admiral Pial De Silva, an experienced underwater diver, declared open the site by cutting a ribbon underwater at the entrance to the museum. The statues in the museum are made from discarded concrete and steel by Navy personnel. One of the aims of the underwater museum project is to promote the regeneration of corals and fish breeding.
අපට අද හැකියාව ලැබිලා තියෙනවා ඉතාමත්ම අලංකාර කෞතුකාගාරයක් දියට ස්ථාපිත කරන්න.
Sri Lanka's multi-billion dollar tourism industry came to a halt in March this year when the country was placed in a lockdown to control the coronavirus spread. The country attracted around 2 million tourists last year and the sector contributes around 11% to the nation's gross domestic product. The lockdown was lifted on 26th of May. There have been 1,947 cases of coronavirus in Sri Lanka, with 11 deaths so far.
At a time when the world is still finding a solution for the highly contagious coronavirus, an India-based textile mill is claiming of producing antiviral fabric that will be used to make masks to fight the deadly virus.
A textile mill, Shiva Texian Limited in India's southern Coimbatore city, is producing antiviral fabric that will be used to make masks to fight the coronavirus. The fabric that has been made using Switzerland-based technology called Viroblock, that is a treatment made on fabric, is capable of killing or deactivating the virus within 3 minutes when it comes in contact with the cloth.
This product has been tested by Hike internationally on the SARS-CoV-2 virus, which is the current virus that is having this pandemic. It's very important because what might work on some viruses might not work on this particular virus. So this chemical has been treated and that is why we chose it. Second, the chemical has a very unique characteristic. It's a very proprietary technology where the deactivation time on the virus is sub 3 minutes.
With the number of coronavirus cases rising each day in India, more and more number of people are wearing masks to protect themselves from getting infected with the deadly virus. First case of the virus in India was reported in January, which since then has infected thousands of people.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.